There are several ways to interpret page value and goal value. For example, if you have an e-commerce site, your page value can be the transaction value of that page. If you have a lead generation site, you might use something like an interpreted value for that lead gen. For example, if your sales team tells you that X amount of leads leads to Y amount of dollars, you could do that calculation and figure out that every lead submitted is worth about $100 to your business. Let's look at what this might look like in Google Analytics. So here you can see we are on our goal page, and this is a goal that I've already set up. I've titled it Lead Submitted, and the goal type is a destination, meaning that we're getting to that page for the lead submission. And our destination is that it's a regular expression equaling new lead underscore thank you, which is the URL of the lead submission page. I've switched my goal value to on, and I've set it to a value of $100, meaning that every time this goal is submitted, we're gonna have a $100 value added to that page. There are also more arbitrary interpretations of what page value or goal value might mean. For example, if you have a newsletter signup, you might not have an actual calculation for how much value a newsletter signup is worth to your business, but you might assign it something arbitrary like $10. If you have a contact us goal, maybe you don't know what the value of this is, but you do know that it's 5 times as important as a newsletter signup. So you wanna be sure that you're assigning that importance relatively, or in this case, that it would be worth $50. Page value is relative. The most important function of page value is to show how pages are performing relative to each other in supporting conversion. Don't focus too much on the page value metrics themselves, but instead as a comparison metric among pages. What if you have a mix of e-commerce and goals? For example, users can purchase items on your website as a guest, but they can also register for an account, which you track as a goal for account registrations. In this case, the overall page value would be based on both e-commerce and goals. And this could be useful for some of your analysis, but you might also want to consider page value just for e-commerce or just for a goal. Let's say you're interested in page value based only on e-commerce. You could create a view that only captures e-commerce and does not define any goals. You could more easily do this with segmentation, where you could define the segment to exclude sessions where a goal occurred. Let's look at an example of this in Google Analytics. So here you can see I've already created a segment and I've called it exclude goal completions. In this case, my condition is set to have goal completions per session equal to 0. A benefit of using a segment is that it's dynamic and retroactive, whereas a filtered view is not. What types of optimization steps can you take based on page value? In the case of the merchandise store, if you filtered your data to see that the registration goal has a high page value, you could make the registration option more prominent to encourage more account creations. If you're using Google Optimize, your page value observations could form the basis of a testing hypothesis, such as making the value prop of account creation more attractive will help your conversion rates.